Templar, 7 Days to Die with Silver Blade.
Damn it, son of a... Ouch.
You must remember to
AKA Miles Power!
Don't you feel foolish?
Greetings, minions, maroon spacefarers, and fellow gamers. This is Silver Blade, playing Imperion Galactic Survival, and definitely not 7 Days to Die, although I do still play that too. This is Alpha 5.5.1. Soon it will be Alpha 6, but for now, 5.1. And this is Episode 2 of Season 6. And in this episode, we are going to continue on with our little newbie quest requirements. And right now, we have to add a turret and ammo box and add O2 in food production. But before we can really do that, especially when it comes to the turret, we need to have a defended structure. And in order to do that, we need walls. Because, yeah, we could do a turret right this minute. But it's better to have a stable base to place it. And when the turret comes into use, there'll be drones, and that means that we'll have to take some fire, so to speak. And that's not exactly a pleasant thing. And as you can see, the large constructor will make the steel plates for us. And I do have these already. So while those are being made, we'll get this in place, but we want to have walls up mainly because when the drones start shooting, we don't want them shooting at our generator, our core, our fuel tank, because that would be bad, and our constructor, the things that we've labored so hard to get put together. So we will make sure they're protected before we get a turret up. Because right now, I can go at those drones with just the assault rifle and draw them away from the base. So that's the weakest kind of protection I can offer right now. So we'll just do this by falling when I don't want to fall. Come on, Silver Boba Fett in there. Ah! Better computer, and I still can't fly with a jetpack worth a damn. Now, if you have seen my older videos and seen me play on my old laptop where I was getting like 10 frames a second, you may recall just how painful that was for me to jetpack around. Alright, so we need to build a wall up around these first. Oh, in my face. Okay, so we will... that. So at least this is somewhat protected. And we're going to get more blocks in here and close it all off, obviously. We do need to leave ourselves an opening so we can get in and out. And we will need a roof. And the roof is where we will put the turret so it has nice line of sight to things. And I do apologize for it being dark, but it is nighttime, and that's the way things are. And it looks like we're going to consume all of our iron, which is a bummer. So what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to, make use of the motorcycle in a little bit. Get this spotlight out here so hopefully we can use it to see. And this is kind of a weird thing because you have to aim it just right, and the ground kind of absorbs the light and all that, and you have to rotate it. Let me see here. I think that's the way it goes. Let's see. Yep, Gotta look for the metal grill on it. Alright, it kinda lights it up. Kinda. Alright, so... we need more iron ingots. Ingots. Okay, and might as well take this moment to unlock the turret. So we'll unlock that. We'll unlock the fridge, because we will be needing that when it comes to the food production. Let's see if there's anything else in here. O2 station, we'll need that for that requirement. We'll also throw in the plant light, but we won't be using that just yet. And we get the food processor for free. Now, let's see, miscellaneous, I believe, is it? Yep. So we need the cargo blocks and the small ammo box, because you can't have the turrets running without an ammo box to feed it the ammo it needs. And we'll, might as well just do that, because it's cheap. Weapons. Can't wait to get the sniper rifle. Tools. I really don't need to worry about texture and symbol tool. When I get to level 7, I'll activate this so I can get the portable work light, because these work lights are a lot better than these. Let's see. I think for now that should do. We can do for hover vessel, small vessel, and capital vessel, but we're not building those right now. And I want to conserve my unlock points for the things that I'm going to need specifically. Otherwise, we're going to have to go XP farming, which we will be doing anyway, as time allows. So we need to go back to the iron mine and grab a bunch more iron. And as I told you guys in the previous episode, that's something you're going to be doing a lot. Going to need a lot is the iron. And there's slimers all over the place. Now, you can swim on the surface without turning on your helmet. If you go to zero, put your crosshairs above the water level like this, you should be able to keep your head above water. If not, you just hit space and it'll bring you back up. Considering I have the jetpack on, that would just make me fly up in the air, splash down into the water, under the water again, and it's just a mess. So you have to kind of do it with kid gloves. So luckily we didn't have to worry about it like that this time. Alright, so try to jetpack over these hills, because they tend to slow you down a bit. And you also kind of have to be careful you don't take too high of a jump, or it'll break your legs when you come down. Or at least it'll hurt you. It doesn't necessarily break your legs like 7 Days to Die does. And we just keep bouncy, 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 bouncy. If you do it just a light little tap, you get moving pretty good. And you won't consume a whole lot of your jetpack, so you can keep bouncing for longer distance. At least that's if you do it right, and I don't always do it right. Alright, so we'll switch to the drill. Get up there. And as you can see, I'm getting experience for every ore that pops out. And as you see, the drill is pretty much not working anymore, and that's because I need to refuel it with biofuel. It's basically just hit R to reload it, and you make biofuel by gathering 5 seaweed to make 1 biofuel tank. So you drill a little bit, pick up your junk, so you don't have it despawn on you. Or roll down the hill, which is up here is quite likely. But yeah, you start off with like five spare tanks of biofuel, and you can continue, but then you'll have to make more as time progresses. But hopefully if you can get to level 7 quick enough, you can get the Type 2 drill, which doesn't require biofuel. And they keep rolling at me. So let's pick up what we dropped. And this is kind of why I want to do a basin in the middle so that it all drops down into it. You just don't want to make it too deep, otherwise you won't be able to get out of it. And as you can see, it bounces you around as the rocks hit you, which is kind of realistic, but also kind of a pain in the ass. Want to get at least all right, we got 172 iron. That should be good for now. I think I'll gather 200 just to be on the safe side. I know I have to come back up here again later, but this should propel us along for the immediate missions that we have. So gather up all of this. What do we got? 202. That should be good enough for now. And as you can see, it's morning. And it's 11 hours and 47 minutes till evening. And it's not exactly real time. And the time will change depending on your movement around the globe. So if you're in a ship and you fly towards the sun as it's setting, it'll be like perpetual dusk or near evening. And if you fly towards the sun when it's coming up, you'll have one really quick-ass day. Alright, so we'll switch to hand. Helmet is off. Let's hope we can keep our head above water. Nope. It says no oxygen, you're drowning, fool. No, I wasn't. But I was when I jumped into the water and went underneath. Oh. Alright, now it is. That's just... they really need to fix that. But luckily it didn't really do me any harm. Much anyway. So let's get this iron in, get it processed, put more blocks in. There we go. go. Alright, so put these in here. And I got a stack of these there. So let's make 100. And it's gonna take a while to get through that. So while we're waiting on that, let's eat. And one thing I want to point out about food, if you look over here to the right of the screen, so one thing of salami gives you 100 food, 10 health, and has a perish time of 52 minutes, and gives you a stamina boost of 10. Now, at the early stages in the game, salami is probably the best food to have because it has the longest perish time. As you progress into the game more, you'll want to go with canned food. I usually prefer the canned tomato and meat because it has like I think it was like 350 minutes of perish time, and if you put it in a refrigerator, it stops the perish clock. So eat that, and we need more meat because I don't think I have any more in here. So let's go hunting. Now, I know there's those slimy little buggers out here. There's one right there, and there's another one not far away from him. So you zoom in with the right mouse button and using the mouse wheel to zoom in. Now you see that the lettering is green. That means they're within your effective range. As you can see in the lower right corner, it says effective range 179 meters. If you have something 200 meters away, obviously you're not going to hit it. So do make note of that. That could save your life by not wasting ammo anyway. Alright, so we can't really do anything with this meat just yet because we don't have a food processor. Now we were using the built-in food processor in the survival constructor to do all that, but we will make a food processor in just a little bit. Just want to make sure we get these all in place. Now there's another way of building this, so you can click, and I think it's space, and you drag, and it'll build a wall like that. So click, shift, drag. If you do it with click, shift, and control, it'll do a plane. So you can do like a whole floor. I don't quite want to do that just yet though, because I don't have enough blocks. And I want to make the ceiling a little bit higher. Oh, get your ass back. Ah, get your ass back up there, boy. Now the easiest way for me to do it anyway is to put a block on each corner. If I can reach it. Click, shift, bam. Click, shift, bam. And I don't get something obstructing the view. All right. Click, shift, shift. Shift, damn you. Alright, and I only have just a handful of blocks left. Should be, yep, there we go. Got some more. Alright, so I want to make the ceiling, let's see, is it one more block level high? Oops. So we'll do the corners again. Now we can do the rest from down here as long as we can see those blocks. So click, shift, drag. Click, shift, drag. Click, shift, drag. So luckily we had just enough blocks to do that. Now we need to do a ceiling. So to do that, click, control, I think. Yeah. So click and control, and you can set the plane just right. As you see, it didn't finish all the way because I ran out of blocks. It's not too big of a deal though. mean, it is, but it isn't. So we can just kind of patch the holes, do it individually, or we can wait until we get enough blocks to actually get the job done right. So while we're waiting on that, what do we need to make? A turret. Okay, alright, we don't need to worry about what parts it requires, but we do need to make sure we have ammo. We also need an ammo box, which is, where is it? Small ammo box, so we'll make that. It didn't make my turret. It's because I ran out of iron. Rawr. Alright, so we got the ammo box. Let's place that. You gotta get on top of, right there. If it would just stay in spot. Boom, right there. So we gotta put our ammo rounds into that. Let's get these blocks finished up here. Go click control and then drag across the plane. We're still coming up short. Dag nabbit. Alright, so we got the ammo box. Let's see. What do we need for... what is it? An oxygen station? Just O2. Alright, so we will do this. If possible, do that. And the food station. Right there. So I get those done at least. Then we can get our food processed, and then we can worry about getting a turret made. And we came short on the metal components is why, so there's that. And it looks like we're not going to be able to get the food processor done. So while we're waiting on that, let's go do another iron run. Let's see what our level is first. Level 5, so once we get to level 7, we can spend our points on the Type 2 drill. And it drills a lot nicer because it's kind of an energy beam. And that energy beam not only reaches better, and it doesn't use biofuel, but it also will automatically grab the nuggets that come out of the ground. So you don't have to go around hunting and pecking to pick up all the balls of ore that fall on the floor. So it's a much better tool than what you initially get with this grinder head on it. And so we'll just kind of boogie on out here. And I do apologize for the repetitiveness, but that's what you're going to have to face should you be playing this game, and you probably should, because this is it's a fun game. And I like that the developers are very active on it, putting out updates quite frequently. The only downside to it, and this is why I haven't done a regular series of Imperion in just over a year now, is because they're doing updates at a rate where it seemed like every couple weeks or every month I'd have to restart the game from scratch, because the newest update would corrupt or make it so that my save games were no good. Now, from what I understand, they've gotten better about it, but, you know, Alpha 6 is coming out soon. Ooh, okay. Let's do some pickup here. And as you can see, some of these just don't want to roll downhill, or they get stuck in a little nooks and crannies like that. You won't have that problem with the Type 2 drill, though. Nice thing also about the Type 2 drill is you can also level terrain or raise terrain or fill in terrain. And I'm out of fuel, so I've got to reload. Let's level these out. So I don't know how long they stick around until they despawn, but I don't want to waste anything. Alright, let's get back to it. Look, I saw you hanging out there. Get him up and see if there's any strays around here. I got 169, and as you know, that stuff goes up quick. We're just going to stick with that, make it back to base, and hopefully I'm on the right side. Yep, okay. Gotta time it just right when you're trying to fly down the mountain like that, because that ground will come up to kiss you on the face pretty damn quick. I hear some critters that need to die. I think it might be those mule lizards. Yep. Now these guys here are docile, but they'll run away when you try to shoot them. But they're worth a good piece of XP. Whoops. And you get milk out of it. And babies, I hate to kill them. They are worth experience points, though. Let's see, where am I at here? Level 5? Alright. We'll just get the meat and the milk and bread and cookies and just head back home. And by the way, you can make both bread and cookies in the game, so, you know, there's that. So we'll boogie on up here. Yeah. So that's one thing that's irritating about this game is the stamina and that heartbeat and all that. It's irritating. You don't have stamina worth shit in the future. Alright, so deposit there, and let's ease away. Okay, so let's see. We got an O2 station, an O2 tank. Now we need processor. And you can see that's all the components for it. Let's get a turret made. And then we'll need to make, we'll make like that many. Oh, that's a lot of ammo, actually. So we'll just... we'll make that much ammo, and you gotta figure it's 50 a piece, or 50 output per one. Not a big deal. And then we need steel blocks by the dozen or 100. Alright, so we can get these put into place. We'll grab the oxygen bottles here. That's ammo sorts. Alright, so where do we want to put the oxygen station? I don't think it really matters, but I'm going to set it right over here. Because I think... Yeah, you gotta have it set like this so you can see the little... nozzles and displays and buttons. Oxygen tank we will put on top because I like to keep them together. And then we got four slots so we can do that. Or five slots rather. And we used a little bit of oxygen to fill up. Okay. Now we got, let's see, we got the food station. So we will rotate that around. Oops, wrong button. We'll just set that there. Let's grab the food items out of here. Meat, milk, aloe vera can go in there. Water. I haven't made any rock dust, but that would also go in to here. Now, as I was saying about canned goods, the canned meat, you know, you need one raw meat, one tomato, five purified water, which is going to be easy to get, and then one steel plate. And that has a perish time of 350 minutes, so it lasts a long time. You can also do a vegetable variant of it, but, eh. it means you have to have an active farm going, whereas... you can make a small farm with just tomatoes and then gathering meat, and you can survive on that for quite some time. Ideally, I would like to make... let's see, where is it? The emergency rations, because they don't have a perish timer. They're immortal. So, there's that. And then cheese, because we got the mule milk. So that's going... let's see, what else? Alright, we got our cannon done, the ammo, probably want some more ammo. Well, we can't make any more because we're out of magnesium. Let's try to get this roof finished off here. So, click, control, if I can get over here. That way, then that way. There we go. So we got the roof on. We will put in a wall here and then put in a doorway. But for right now, let me see if I can Boba Fett my way. Hold on. I need to make sure I got everything. Okay. So let me get this out of your face. Ammo box. Oops. Not going to be able to reach it that easy. So deposit the bullets into that, and we need to Boba Fett, as I call it, up to the roof, and I don't have enough fuel. Alright, so let me recharge a little bit, get a running start. Ooh, Bailey, you squeaked it up there. Okay. So we'll put, let's see which direction we're at. I'm thinking I'll put the turret up here on this corner. I'm going to make three other turrets so they're on each corner. I'll get inside. Now, as you can see, you can move it around, and now all you have to really do, it'll do it automatically, but I prefer to do it manually when I first install them. Hit R, and it should load up the gun. Bang, bang. So now, what we'll do is we'll hit P, and this will show the control panel for the base. You have to be standing on it for it to work. Cannon turret, now I'm going to shut off on Predator, Core, Thruster, and Generator. So basically aim at weapons. It's not really going to make a big deal, but in this case here, it'll shoot at aliens and other factions. I don't want it to shoot at prey or predators, because I want to be able to kill them myself. But I can't remember which, if it's counted as other factions or aliens, but one of these will make it so that the cannon will shoot drones. The other will make it shoot whatever else, but I just usually just keep these two toggled, and that way if any enemies come near my base, the cannons will take care of it. On my ships, I usually have it so it aims at turrets and mounted weapons, because I don't want it to kill cores, because usually it means it's going to shoot a lot and through a lot of armor and stuff that I probably don't want destroyed. Same with thrusters and generators. So basically I just have it aim for the weapons, and I will personally take out thrusters, generators, and cores as I deem necessary. So that's how I usually set up turrets, both on bases and on ships. So that's all loaded and ready for bear. I'm going to have to make a means of getting up to the roof in an easier fashion, as well as getting inside here, but that's going to be for another episode. So right now, let's get some food in me. And I'm going to want to eat the cheese first, because that's got a 23-minute perish time. Now, cheese is also an ingredient that you can make into more complex meals. Say, like, let's see, there's a cheeseburger in here. Yeah, meat burger. There's a pizza. You know, some of that requires some cheese, so you won't want to eat it right necessarily straight out, but, you know, there's that. Also, let's see if I can get a refrigerator made. Indeed, I can. The Type 2 is bigger, and thus better. And, oh, hold on. Okay, we'll do that. And then I ran out of ore, so I have to go and do some more mining. I'll do that off camera, though. But yeah, I want to get that refrigerator going, because then I could take the meat and the cheese and stuff like that that has a perish time and make it so it stays viable for a lot longer. So anyways, guys, it's been a busy episode. I hope you enjoyed it. Do check out the links in the description box below. All of them are vital, particularly the links to other people's channels. Check them out. Subscribe to them. Like their content. Tell them Silverblade sent you. And until next time, see you later. Twitch, Twitch.